Hey guys, welcome to a new vlog. Right now I am preparing to go to my cousin's ballet recital in Pretoria, so you guys should expect that, and then shortly after that we'll do some market stuff. Let us go to Pretoria. Hey guys, struggling with the baby, but yeah, so far so good.
Come to me.
I just want to show you guys a few trades that I am currently in. We are currently looking at GBP USD on the 15-minute chart. Let's start on the 1 hour because that is where I actually analyzed this. So I have my area of sensitivity right there, and what I was waiting for the market to come, and then I would wait and see how the market would react to this area. Now if you take a close look, the market didn't even touch the area, it just went down from there. And then going down onto the 15-minute chart, you can see from here that the market did a double top, which was one indication for me. And then let's look at MetaTrader, because I also look at MetaTrader. So on MetaTrader, you can see also that it's at the top of a channel. Take profit is all the way down here, but I would like to see if market will come here. All right, but we're going in, we're still in good profits. I have a 1000 ZAR account, and that's the profit that we're running at the moment. I'm thinking of closing this trade because I've literally reached my target for today. Let me just leave one. I want to trust my take profit area. Hey guys, welcome to another video. Right now I'm actually at okay. Just wanted to show you guys the trades that I am in. I'm in a GU buy. Let me do this. Yeah. GU buy that I don't know. I'm not sure if it'll go as planned. Yeah. GU buy. I don't know if it'll go as planned. My stop loss is supposed to be here. Let me show you guys. I hope you guys can see this line. Or rather, let me do this maybe. My stop loss is supposed to be here by this black line. I hope you guys can see it, like right under here. But because I know that the market will want to manipulate and stuff, it might actually draw a wick and go over this black line and come maybe down there, you know, and then go back up. So the reason why I've entered this is because I see that the market is creating a double bottom. Let me see if I can draw it with this. Okay. So, hey guys, this is difficult, but yeah, I could see like a double bottom being created over there. And then when I zoom in, I don't know if you guys can see when I zoom in closer, there's this candlestick that is like it's an order block in my box. So there is this big engulfing that is bullish, and then there is the bearish that is like a butterfly going up that is black. And then there is also this candlestick up there that is like bullish. Now, because I've seen that, and it's like, it's actually like 8 right now. So in South Africa, it means that at 9 or 10 a.m., New York session, London session is gonna open. So I would like to see London session opening with my market going bullish. And then it'll go bullish, and then I would like to see it maybe come down and then go up. I'll show you guys nicely on TradingView what I'm talking about, or rather maybe let's move into TradingView on my phone, because I've got TradingView on my phone too. It's this channel going down, and then the market is right there at the bottom of the channel, and this is an area of sensitivity. When we move this way, you see market came here, bounced here, bounced on this area. So this area has a lot of information. So this area is an area that I, for my strategy, it says that I must buy at that area. So I kind of missed the buy area because I was asleep. So I was trying to buy it at a discount, you see. So the first position that you guys see here, the first long position that you see, was that first entry was right there. But then I knew that the market has to come back to the candlestick there.
that I showed you guys in the previous chart on MetaTrader, and then that's where the market is right now. So market took me in on my buy limit. Excuse me. So now I'm looking to see if the market will go up or the market will come to the thingy. So this is my actual take profit. I'm gonna put an alert here, so when market comes to this area, it's gonna alert me, and then I'm gonna look to see how the candlestick closes there. If the candlestick closes there and it's alerting me that the market is actually still bullish, I'm gonna leave the trades. If the market or the candlestick signals to me that it's going to be bearish, then I'm going to close the trades. Yeah, that's karabo, guys.
Oh yeah, okay now.
I don't hang with rats, that's some new type shit. Get a nigga wet, don't new type shit. Sipping, drinking, acting on screw type shit. Just say
it, huh? Yeah, sure, feel it. Yeah. Welcome to the panda. In our hood language, panda means hustle. Mm-hmm. But yeah, panda is a store.
I'm back home. And these are the profits that I'm running. I'm actually thinking of closing some of the trades. Plus, like, I've reached like my target for the day. So one TP is about to be hit, and like something tells me, like, just close these trades and be done for the day. My equity is on 600 and my mom from 500. So yeah, you know, I'm thinking of closing at least this one. This one. Okay. Let's wait for it to say 200. You see, we can leave those one. Now my balance is 600. Now let me just move stop loss to entry. You see? Now we move stop loss to entry point because we want when the market comes and it retraces. Can retrace on the entry. Now let's see. I have one 0.2 open and a 0.1. And if Hey guys, ended up closing the trades because I had reached my target of the day. It was just supposed to be me making 100 rand, and yeah, I made 200 rand. So that's my goal. Every day, if I could make like 100 rand, I know I'm good, you know, until the point where I've made the money that I want to make, and then I can up my lot size. But I said this red area, that's where I'd like to see the market go to, but the market hardly even arrived into the red area and had made my profit. And I was watching the GOAT Andy's interview today with Top Trader SA, and the nigga was like, you need to trade your position, not the money. The money will come after, but the position. That's also something that I preach, you know. But sometimes you have a goal, and if you have a goal, man, you need to reach your goal. Like, fuck the take profit, fuck the stop loss. The market, even if the market does reach your take profit, You just need to be proud and know that, yeah, market reached my take profit. The more your confidence grows in the market, hey guys. So what's happening right now is that I'm thinking of withdrawing like 200 rand from my trading account, the 200 rand that I just made, because I need it. So I'm in XM. This is what it looks like. XM, please work with me. Yo, I love XM, guys. But the problem with these brokers is that they don't want to pay. I was watching the Goat Andy's podcast this morning, and he was... I think I made reference to the podcast twice now. But yeah, I watched these podcasts. Now, this nigga was saying, like, prop firms pay. So I was thinking of jumping onto the prop firm space. Kind of, how do I withdraw? Oh, here it is. XM member area. I'm gonna say withdraw. Visa. I'm gonna withdraw 200 rand. I just don't like relying on my trading account money to do things, because this way, like, it doesn't give the money or the account time to grow. So I've been asking my uncle for a job, and like the job is like kind of degrading, like picking up papers there by but he don't understand. Like, I don't have debts. I just want to trade knowing that I've got money coming in on the side. But man, it is what it is, man. And then, yeah, guys, people have asked me, like, how do you balance trading in school? Like, this literally, this is how I do it. Number one, I'm a full-time student, but I do it through UNISA, so I'm doing like online. Sometimes I'm out in the streets like I was today, and I still trade on the go. You know, that's just me, that's how I do it. Morning, guys. Yo, I sound like Bafo. But good morning, guys, welcome to the video, because I've already started a video. Not sure if it was yesterday or the day before yesterday, but we already started a vlog, and I showed you guys the buy position that I was in, and then I closed, and then I withdrew that money. I don't really like what happened yesterday, me withdrawing, because I feel like I don't see where I'm going. It's like when I am relying on that trading money. By the way, I'm not working anymore. I'm not job hunting. I'm focusing only on school, which is a really, really good thing, because like my results, it's also reflecting in my results. Like, my results are not the same as the results that I would get when I was trading, doing school, and working. I had to sacrifice trading a lot then, but now I don't have to sacrifice trading, which is a good thing. So what's happening right now is that I'm waiting for the withdrawal, and oh yeah, I was also looking at the chart, so I just want to show you guys what I'm looking at right now. So this is what I'm looking at today. You see, I'm trying to see if the market will go up from here. This will be my stop loss, and then if it'll go up until maybe this level. But it would be nice if it like went over this level too. Yeah, but at the same time, there is this level right here that the market could have just went to retest and then go down. So right now what I'm trying to see is if the market will retest this angle, this level right. Let me just make my levels red now. So that level right there, I'm trying to see how the market will react to this level right now, right there. If it breaks it and then retests, I'm taking the buy to the upside, but it's going to be a quick buy. It would probably be more visible on the 15 minute chart. On the 15 minute chart, you see. But this is a typical double bottom that I love to trade. So I don't know if you see this. So that's why my first analysis, or my first thought process, is that if the market breaks this area, retraces, I'm taking the retrace till here. This is going to be my first take profit. and then we'll see. Yesterday, this was my first take profit, which was a hit. And then I could tell that the market was going down. No candlesticks talk, guys. I could see that, nah, like the buyers don't have momentum anymore. And it made a lot of sense for the market to just come up to here and play, because look at this. Let me show you guys something about like market psychology, right? Market psychology, if it's really gonna go up, it has to go back to the line and touch the line and go. So it came, touched the line once, touched the line twice, third time touch, went up. Came, touched the line once, twice, you know, here it came down. But look at what it did here. It's like 1, 2, came down, but then went up again to touch. You got touch, third touch, and then came down to the bottom of the channel. So this is not really like a good confirmation for me that the market is actually going up, you know. It would have been nice if the market came touch a couple of times here and then went up.
Hey guys, still the same day. I ended up entering the trade. Let me show you guys. I entered the trade on the 1 hour chart. As you know, like I'm a day trader, so trading on the 1 hour. I've entered my trade. My stop loss is here. I have an alarm here. Ooh. Like, oh God, what's happening? My actual stop loss is here. So this is an area where when the market comes here, I stop and look how the market is closing. You see the candlesticks are closing. So yeah, I've got two buys here, a 0.1 and a 0.2. And then looking to see how everything will go. It's currently 5 minutes past 9 a.m. So yeah, we've hit stop loss. Clearly we're going down. Let me show you what I was looking at. MetaTrader 4 was the channels going down. I kind of noticed that the market wants to go down from there. I should have sold instead of buy, but you know what, it's cool. I'm not gonna react, I'm just gonna watch the market and see what it does. If it breaks this area, retraces, I'll take the buy. I mean the sell. But that should happen during New York session. So I'm waiting for New York session. Still too early. Still too early right now. So yeah. Exit. You're watching that. It's going down. It is what it is. Let's see how it reacts. And then yeah.
Hey guys, I'm still in bed. I was watching this movie called Babes. Let me show you guys. This movie right here. Really, really great movie. It was an amazing movie. Like, I don't wanna kill it for you guys, but yeah. I don't watch stuff on Netflix anymore since I don't have a job anymore. So I can't commit to such things. So I don't have Netflix anymore. So I stream on Tiny Zone. And there's another one that my cousin introduced me to. It's called, hold on, I'll tell you guys. Gojara. Let me show you guys. But here it is. This one right here. This one right here. And then there's that. And then I save stuff from here. I download from here. The thing about me is that I'm very resourceful, okay? So if this is illegal, I am sorry, but I need entertainment. And another thing is that I haven't been watching stuff for the past week and a half. Last week and that other week because of school. Like, I was preparing for school, I had assignments due. So now I don't have stuff that I'm doing, you know. This is how I spend my days. Sometimes I'm not watching stuff, I'm actually reading books. Sometimes I go out and play golf. I started playing golf. I haven't really like started, but I've got all of the equipment. And one of the days we'll go out and play golf somewhere, maybe in the yard, because you know. And I also the piano, that's another thing that like I started doing, because
I figured like if I'm not working, I need hobbies. You know, I need hobbies. And then the gym, I really want to do the gym because I really, really, really want to lose weight. Like, that's like my main goal right now. Other than like the forks in school, gym is my goal. So another thing that I was doing today is editing a vlog, my Gold Reef City vlog. The editing is supposed to be done and up by now. Maybe I'll have it up by tomorrow. And then before I have it up, I will reply to all of the comments that I had. That's the plan right now. And then, yeah, guys, I'm just chilling, you know. This is how I spend my days. This is a realistic day. I don't, like, my idealistic daily routine is not lazy like this. I'm just having a lazy day. Oh, yeah, I actually picked up the camera because I wanted to show you guys something with GU. As I was training GU in the morning and then, stop loss got hit and I don't want to enter again because I've used up all of my risk for today. So I really, really don't want to get involved in the trade, but I just wanted to show you guys what's happening. Market came there, is this a fake out or what? I don't know. So I'm looking to see if market will come retrace here and then go down from there or whatever, but I'm not trading. You know, like, as a forex trader, you need to protect your capital. That's the name of the game. Protect your capital. You need to have discipline to say, you know what, like, I've used up my risk for the day, I'm done trading. Let me show you guys my trades, by the way, so that it doesn't look like I'm just talking, you know. I don't even know where my phone is. Oh my gosh, guys. I spoke to my friend and then what happened? Okay, I'll find my phone. Maybe let me show you guys on the PC on MetaTrader. But okay, let's go in there and then let's do history. Yeah. I withdrew the other day. Yeah. The other day I made profits, I withdrew, and then these are the profits that I made recently that I withdrew like a couple of days ago. I'm just waiting for that. And then these are like my, this was my loss of today. I was supposed to make a lot of money today, so that added on to that, which is kind of annoying, you know, really, really kind of annoying. But I'm gonna make this back, you know. But also, this account, guys, this is not the account that I you know, I've deposited this much from the account. I've deposited this much into this account and withdrew this much from the account. So now the goal is for this to be more than this. And look at what the market is doing now on the 4-hour chart. This is what I don't like about trading. If you ask me, like, what's the one thing that you hate about trading, it's literally this. Like, I'll do my analysis, see where the market is going, enter earlier than I was supposed to, and then this happens. And this is just so annoying to me. It's really, really annoying, but it's cool. I will look at what where I went wrong and that sort of thing. So yeah, this is what I do. These are my days. I'm gonna bath a little later though. If I'm not at a nice restaurant treating myself to lunch, or if I don't go to the gym, I'm just sitting like this, reading a book.
Hi, Baba. Hello, no much. How are you? Okay. I can't.
That's all come again.
Yeah, I can't.
Hey guys, same day. I don't know if I didn't show you guys the trades on my phone nicely, but I just want to show you guys those trades that I lost. I'm with my cousin Karabo, and I said to him, the problem with me is that I trust myself too much. And then I re-entered those trades. Let me show you guys. So I hope you guys can see. Yeah. Let me do this. Yeah. So basically these are the trades, right? This is the account. This is today. As you can see the date, it's 8th of August. So today, this was my loss. These are my losses for today. I entered this again because, man, I had faith in my trade, you know. And then I re-entered. Like, this is what I was expecting the market to do today, you know, for it to go up. I don't know up until where, but right now we're running on profit of 60, and we had 500 rand in the account. I don't know if you guys remember that, you know. And man, this is where we are right now. But this is the account balance, this is the equity, these are the profits, right? So now I don't know if I should just close this trade or leave it running, but I've moved my stop loss to entry point. And yeah, but I'd like to see the market come to this red area. That's where I wanted the market or the trade to go to. But it just so happened that, you know, it took me out, and that's because the market maker knows that where we put our stop losses. And that's one thing that I forgot to take into consideration today when I looked at my trades and I studied everything. But I was sure that the market is really going up today. So basically that's where we are today. I re-entered. This is the position that we spoke about earlier on today, that I'm seeing a double bottom. Double bottom right there. So other people will say left shoulder, head, right shoulder, up. You see, some people will look at that and say that, you see. And but I was looking at it as a double bottom, but I'm looking to see if market will reach this area right here, because this one we've already reached, you know. And I'd like to see if the market will reach that area right there. But to be more accurate, let's look on my phone. See, it's still going up, steady going up. I can't enter again now because of psychology, you know. I don't want to blow my account now, you know. So yeah.
Welcome back to another episode. Today we'll be having my sister speak.
That's
how you do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
This song.
5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, my dad.
Record.
Okay. Is it going?
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4, 5, 6, 7,
Hey guys, I just came from my grandmother's house. My cousin had a little lunch situation happening there, so yeah. My nieces and cousins were in charge of vlogging. I don't know if they vlogged. I wanted us to recap on the traits that I took these past 2 days. Today's Friday, by the way. So these past 2 days were really interesting to me. I learned a few things about the market that I saw last week, because prior to last week I wasn't really placing trades, right? I don't know if you watched that previous video of mine where it was a month in my life, a month of my non-trading life. In that video I did mention that I'm not focused, I keep missing trades. I wasn't placing trades, I would just miss trades, and it just wasn't like pleasant experience for me. So yeah, right now I want us to recap on the trades that I took for the past 2 days, and then we'll take it from there. The market is at the bottom of the channel. It's a Tuesday. I'm anticipating it to go up. I wish you guys could see my face when I'm saying this, but you know what, unfortunately you cannot. But I have a midweek reversal phenomenon where if the market was going down on a Tuesday, on a Wednesday it's definitely changing direction, okay? Or on that Tuesday it's drawing patterns that indicate to me that the market is really changing direction the next day, right? And then what usually happens is that when New York's London session opens in the morning, the market will kind of spike into that direction, and then just before New York session opens and just after just before New York session opens, market will correct itself or retrace a broken area and continue to that side, right, to whatever side. So let's wait for Tuesday, Wednesday. Cool, market is here on Wednesday. So I am anticipating the market to break this area right here. Okay, so the yellow is me being in profit and gray is me being in loss. So I'm expecting the market to break this, retrace, come here, break, maybe go up something, you know. But let's see what the market does. Okay, this is Wednesday morning, 6 a.m. cool, 6 a.m. market definitely does break. Okay, break this, comes, retraces, I enter, goes up. Okay, I'm gonna show you guys some things also on MetaTrader 4, right, like my history and stuff like that. And then I enter, and then market does this, it corrects before it actually goes up. Okay, market goes up. I'm like, okay cool, I'm done with this, because at this point the market was supposed to like go up, 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 but that doesn't happen. Okay cool, I exit, I make my money, I withdraw my money, cool. And then the next day, then for the rest of the day, I'm like, cool, whatever happens happens. But then remember, midweek reversal on the Wednesday. So now here I'm trying to see if the market will do a double bottom and then up or what, like I'm trying to see that. But now this is what the market does, guys. I enter the trade, the market flipping takes me out. I want you guys to see this, takes me the hell out here, right? And then look at what it does. Goes straight to my take profit and beyond that today. And today, so it's continuing to the upside, right? Now this is the market, right, continuing to the upside. Now let's look at MetaTrader 4.